Greetings, beloved brothers and sisters. Welcome to our virtual sanctuary. Please refrain from all posting in the chat unless requested to do so. Be assured that the Lord hears your amens and sees you even though others do not. 1 Symbolic Code 13, page 3, paragraph 7 and 8 says, "When the worshippers enter the place of meeting, they should do so with decorum, passing quietly to their seat. If there is a stove in the room, it is not proper to crowd about it in an indolent, careless attitude. Common talking, whispering, and laughing should not be permitted in the house of worship, either before or after the service. Ardent, active piety should characterize the worshipers. If some have to wait a few minutes before the meeting begins, let them maintain a true spirit of devotion by silent meditation, keeping the heart uplifted to God in prayer, that the service may be of special benefit to their own hearts and leading to the conviction and conversion of other souls. They should remember that heavenly messengers are in the house. The whispering and laughing and talking, which might be without sin in a common business place, should find no sanction in the house where God is worshipped." Testimonies for the Church, Volume 5, page 492. While joining the meeting, please enter your two-digit division code, followed by a single space, then a dash, followed by another single space. Then put BRO dot brothers, SIS dot sisters before your full name while joining. Example, SIS dot Ellen White. Family after your family name. Example, BRO dot James White's family. Name of your church or group. Example, Munsey Church or Munsey Group. Each first and last name should begin with a capital letter. Maintain strict reverence during the meeting. If you have a question during the presentation, note down the slide number so that when question time comes, you can be served effectively. The slide number is found at the bottom right corner of the slide in the presentation, which is at the bottom right hand of your screen. Your question may not be taken if you do not have a slide number. When question and answer time comes, make sure to raise your hand when you have a question, and you will be added to the question schedule on the chat. If you have called in using a regular phone, you can raise your hand by dialing star 9. Once you see your time comes to speak, you will be called upon by the host. If you are on the phone, you can press star 6 to toggle mute or unmute. Please do not lower your hand. The host will do that for you. If you have another question, please raise your hand again and follow the procedures above. Also, while inviting someone new to the meeting, please make sure to acquaint them with our meeting protocol. Finally, should you experience any problems during the meeting, please follow the following procedures to send a chat to the host, and you will be assisted accordingly. Click the chat icon in the meeting controls. In the two drop-down menu, select host. Enter your message in the chat window. Press enter to send your message. Thank you for observing reverence and for your good behavior in the house of God. Welcome again and God bless.
Amen. Greetings, brethren. Happy Sabbath. Can I be heard?
Greetings, sister. You can be heard.
Amen. Thank you. I take this opportunity to welcome us all to Western Hemisphere Bible Study. And before we begin, I could like us to humbly kneel to open with a word of prayer. Let's pray. Our dear Lord in heaven, we humbly come unto thy presence at this moment. We pray and ask that the Holy Spirit to guide and lead us as we plan to enter into our study this afternoon. We thank you for the gift of the Sabbath and many gifts that thou hast given us. We thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit who has been leading us since the Sabbath began up to this moment. We thank thee that thou hast enlightened our mind, that thou hast brought us out of the world unto thy fold. How we pray for those who are ministers and for those who are opposing this truth, that you may open their eyes spiritually. You can open their hearts for them to see the truth in thy presence, truth in thy message of thy word. Lord, even as our ministers, we pray that you give us understanding and you give us the knowledge that comes from thee so that we can truly live this message and live it to the end, so that we can be saved and not be lost. Lord, we pray that you give us a good connection and you bless everyone and each of us connected in this line, that at the end of this study, we will be blessed and our hearts will be moved closer to thee, so that you prepare us into thy kingdom. Forgive us and cleanse us from our evil ways. Bless our family members. Bless everybody and each of us, Lord. These mercies I ask by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit and in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you. At this time, we're going to enter into our song service. Any of us with a song can raise their hand so that you can be selected to present your song. Can I still be heard?
Yes, you can be heard, my dear sister.
Is there anyone with a song to raise their hand? Okay, I can't see anyone. I could like to sing 523, my faith has found a resting place. My faith has found a resting place, not in a man-made creed. I trust the ever-living one that he for me will plead. I need no other evidence, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died and rose again for me. Enough for me that Jesus says, this ends my fear and doubt. A sinful soul, I come to him, he will not cast me out. I need no other evidence, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died and rose again for me. The great physician healed the sick, the lost he came to save. For me is precious blood he shed, for me is life he gave. I need no other evidence, I need no other plea. It is enough that Jesus died and rose again for me. Amen.
I have a song, I can't raise my hand.
We have a sister Angela. You can go ahead, my sister. Sister Angela, you can unmute.
Sorry about that. Greetings, brothers and sisters. The name of the song I'm about to sing is called Ella Baxter Box. The room grew still as she made her way to Jesus. She stumbled through the tears that made her blind. She felt such pain, some spoke in anger, heard folks whisper, there's no place here for her kind. Still alone she came, through the shame that flushed her face, until at last she knelt before his feet. And though she spoke no words, everything she said was heard as she poured her love for the master from a box of alabaster. I've come to pour my praise on him like all from Mary's alabaster box. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and I dry them with my hair, you won't dare. The night he found me, you did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his love all around me. And you don't know the cost of the oil in my aloe Baxter box. I can't forget the way life used to be. I was a prisoner to the sin that had me bound. I spent my days, poured my life without measure into a little treasure box I thought I found. Until the day when Jesus came to me and healed my soul, what the wonders of his touch. So now I'm giving back to him all the praise he's worthy of. I've been forgiven, and that's why I love him so much. I've come to pour my praise on him like oil from Mary's aloe Baxter box. Don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and I dry them with my hair. You won't dare. The night Jesus found me, you did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his loving arms around me. And you don't know the cost of the oil. You don't know the cost of my praise. You don't know the cost of the oil in my aloe Baxter box. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, my sister. Now it's another time that I welcome our presenter, Brother Lennox. Sister Shemida, next time you'll have a chance to sing. Brother Lennox, you're welcomed. Can I still be heard?
Yes, you can be heard. Maybe Brother Sam is setting up.
I guess I am. I was on mute. I was on mute. Sorry. Praise his holy name. Praise his holy name. Bless the Lord. You weren't there. My alabaster box. Beautiful, beautiful. Enjoy that song. Happy Sabbath, everyone. Am I still audible? Yes.
Yes. Yes, you are. You are audible.
It's a cloudy, wintry day In Waco, Texas, looks like finally we will get a taste of winter. Okay. A prayer thought is taken from early writings, page 149. We're going to read paragraph 2. Sorrow-filled heaven. As it was realized that man was lost, and that world which God had created was to be filled with mortals doomed to misery, sickness, and death. And there was no way of escape for the offender. The whole family of Adam must die. I saw the lovely Jesus and beheld an expression of sympathy and sorrow upon his countenance. Soon I saw him approach the exceeding bright light which enshrouded the Father. Said my accompanying angel, he is in close converse with his Father. The anxiety of the angel seemed to be intense while Jesus was communing with the Father. Three times he was shut in by the glorious light about the Father. And the third time he came from the Father, his person could be seen. His countenance was calm, free from all perplexity and doubt, and shone with benevolence and loveliness such as words cannot express. He then made known to the angelic hosts that a way of escape had been made for lost man. He told them that he had been pleading with his Father and had offered to give his life a ransom, to take the sentence of death upon himself, that through him man might find pardon, that through the merits of his blood and obedience to the law of God, they could have the favor of God. And he brought into the beautiful garden and be brought into the beautiful garden and eat of the fruit of the tree of life. What a sad day it was in heaven when the holy pair fell to the sophistry of the enemy of mankind, bringing misery, sickness, and death. All of heaven was suffering. Sympathy, the love of God had turned from him. But the Son three times pleaded with the Father, and finally the Father said, let it be done. And that's why, my dearly beloved, we're here We're here because the Father so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten Son. And all we have to do is accept and be obedient. And we will all eat of the tree of life and live forever and ever through the ceaseless days of eternity. What a sacrifice. What a God we serve. Shall we pray? Our Father and our God, help us, teach us, gratitude. Help us to recognize the gift that we received. Help us, Lord, to truly accept the sacrifice that our Lord and Savior made on our behalf. And as now, as then, as heaven was looking on with intense interest, even so, Lord, we know heaven again is looking on with intense interest as we come to the climax of the plan of salvation. Holy Father, help us to recognize the time in which we are living. Help us, Lord, to be ready. We know, Father, that is a full knowledge of the truth that will make us ready, and a relationship with Thee. Help us, Lord. Bless us this evening as we continue the ceremonial harvest. Help us to understand that the harvest of humanity, of those who shall be translated, is soon to begin. Let us not lose sight. Put a hedge around us, O Holy Father. These mercies we ask in the precious holy name, our Redeemer, our King, our great sacrifice, and in the, by the inspiration of Thy Spirit, we pray and believe. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We will continue our quiz. And our quiz is ceremonial harvest and its significance. We're now focusing on the living. And we will continue where I give the illustration, you give the reference to support the illustration. I believe we have covered that. And is it here we are?
Yes. That's okay. Where we live.
Mm-hmm. Antitypical harvests. I've illustrated to be the harvest of humanity. And references on the harvest of humanity and being the antitypical harvest, the antitype. References to support the antitypical harvest of humanity. And it's, of course, a collection of references. Or maybe you'll be able to have just one. Okay. Everyone remember?
Yeah, reference. We have a brother.
Okay.
Brother group.
Okay.
Salutations, Jesus Christ.
Greetings in Jesus Christ.
Ma référence est le tract 3, page.
My reference is in track number 3, page 82.
Paragraph 4.
Paragraph 4.
Mm-hmm.
So, you said, as the light focusing to this point clearly reveals that the Pentecost after the resurrection was for the ingathering of those who were to die, there must correspondingly be a Pentecost for the ingathering of those who are to be translated. And by the same token of logic, the wave shift and the wave loaves must have a double application, each to the dead and to the living, together comprising the total fruits of the antitypical harvest.
Donc là, il est écrit selon.
So it is written.
On voit bien qu'il y a une double application pour les morts et les vivants.
For the dead and the living.
Et l'ensemble représente la moisson antitypique.
Together comprising the total fruits, we see they represent the antitypical harvest.
Okay, and how do we know it's the harvest of humanity?
Parce que cela englobe,
the living, so it is the whole history of the humanity.
Okay. In other words, here we see it says together. So we're told of the dead and the living separately. And then the rod says together. So they have to come together. And they comprise the total fruits of the antitypical harvest. And we know wave sheaf and wave loaf is limited only to the first fruits, not the entire harvest. So we know this is, we must see wave sheaf, wave loaf among the dead, the living, and then they must come together for the antitypical harvest. But explanation, yes, but is there another statement that helps us know that there is going to be a harvest of humanity, or it is to be coming together of the two? Now, do you have the other statement, or you want to?
Le tract 3, page 75, paragraph 2.
Page 75, paragraph 2, on the same track.
Okay, go ahead.
Illustrating our salvation in completeness, the harvest rites of the ceremonial system must therefore corroborate both the testimonies of the prophets and the parables concerning the harvest, for all are inextricably bound up together. The ceremonies of the first and the second fruits of grain must accordingly unfold the truth concerning the first and second fruits of humanity. In the Leviticus law, we read.
What come after? On peut lire le paragraphe suivant.
We can read the following paragraph. He shall bring a sheaf of the first fruits of your harvest unto the priest, and he shall wave the sheaf before the Lord to be accepted for you on the morrow after the Sabbath. The priest shall wave it, and ye shall eat neither bread nor parched corn nor green ears until the self same day that ye have brought an offering unto your God. And ye shall count unto you from the morrow after the Sabbath, from the day that ye brought the sheaf of the wave offering, 7 day Sabbaths shall be complete.
Le paragraphe suivant.
Even unto the morrow after the seventh Sabbath shall ye number 50 days, and ye shall offer a new meat offering unto the Lord. Ye shall bring out of your habitations 2 wave loaves of 2/10 deals. They shall be of fine flour. They shall be baked with leaven. They are the first fruits unto the Lord. Also in the 15th day of the 7th month, when ye have gathered in the fruit of the land, ye shall keep a feast unto the Lord 7 days. On the first day shall be a Sabbath, and on the 8th day shall be a Sabbath. Leviticus 23, verse 10, 11, 14 to 17, and verse 39.
Et le dernier paragraphe, le paragraphe suivant.
And the following paragraphs, the last one. Here we see commended the observance of the 3 harvest rites. 1, the ceremony of the wave sheaf at the beginning of the first harvest. 2, the ceremony of the wave loaves at the close of the first harvest. And 3, the Feast of Tabernacles at the close of the second harvest. being typical, these two grain harvests with their three literal sacraments accordingly foreshadow two soul harvests with three spiritual rites, the first of which is the first fruit with wave sheaf and wave loaves.
Et si on retourne au paragraphe 2?
And if we go back to the paragraph number 2.
Il est bien dit que les cérémonies attachées à la moisson
des premiers
et des seconds fruits des céréales doivent the ceremonies
of the first and the second fruits of grain must accordingly.
Donc, et les paragraphes suivants nous détaillent.
Unfold the truth concerning the first and second fruits of humanity, and the following paragraphs tells us what it is. So when we understand,
quand on comprend les cérémonies. C'est-à-dire
the ceremonies, so it means, namely, wave sheaf and wave loaves.
On peut comprendre la vérité we can understand the truth concerning
the first and the second fruits of humanity, and the first and second fruits of grain, because they are tied, they are bound up together.
Okay. So this statement shows that the first and second fruits of the grain must unfold the truth of humanity. And the statement could be argued, this statement could be argued that this is just referring to just each dead and living, but no, it's not, because we are told already that there is a coming together. So you cannot divorce the coming together, because there is a coming together, and Christ is definitely not coming for the dead or the living separately. It's coming for the harvest of humanity. Okay. Any other statements to climax?
We have Sister Jillian.
Greetings, Brother Lennox. Greetings, Church.
Greetings.
Thank you. I have, to begin with, it's a few, but they're short. 2TG, number 46, page 27, paragraph 3, to begin. To get into the full beam of light, we must first face the fact that the pre-Pentecostal harvest took place in a self-deceived church, the Jewish, and through miracle work and power manifested by Christ himself, it yielded the 120 disciples, the first fruits of those who are to be resurrected, whereas the post-Pentecostal harvest took place among the nations, and through miracle power manifested by the spirit-filled 120 disciples, it yielded an innumerable multitude of converts to Christianity, the second fruits of those who are to be resurrected. In that reference, and there, all the references I'm going to use is in that same TG, but that reference was showing the pre-Pentecostal harvest. And since we're talking about the harvest of humanity, which includes the resurrected and the translated, if I have permission to go on to conclude my point of using these references to answer the illustration, I will continue with 28.1.
And you said this reference is showing the pre-Pentecostal harvest?
Well, those who could have expound died. A little? Say that again?
Could you expound a little on that? I'm not sure.
Why I say it's the pre... Well, from what is being stated, the pre-Pentecostal harvest, which took place in the South the Sea Church, the Jewish, but Christ himself, he yielded the pre-Pentecostal that I'm talking about is the 120, the first fruits of those who were to be resurrected. And they bringing in a great multitude of converts, the second fruits of those who are to be resurrected. That was a harvest in itself among the dead.
Okay.
And so as we go forward to page 28, paragraph 1, I'm going to get to the antitype, and that will cover humanity. And it says, now, to summarize the times before the Pentecost, which is in addition to that reference just read, one, the first fruits were numbered. Two, they came exclusively from the church itself. Three, the miracles then wrought were by Christ himself. Now going forth to 28, paragraph 2. Now coming to the types after the Pentecost, one, the second fruits were not numbered. Two, they came from the nations. Three, the miracles then wrought were by the numbered ones, the 120, the first fruits. And I'll use this last reference then explain what I'm seeing to answer the illustration. I just need them all to... because we're still on the dead, and humanity involves living and dead, all that should be saved from Adam to the last saint to be saved among the living. So page 28, paragraph 3 will be the last reference I use, and then sum up. Accordingly, the antitypical, now we're coming forward to us today, the living. Accordingly, the antitypical pre-Pentecostal harvest takes place in the self-deceived church, the Laodicean, the house of God, and through miracle-working power manifested by heaven itself in the angels, it yields the 144,000, the first fruits of those who are never to die. Whereas the antitypical post-Pentecostal harvest takes place among the nations and through miracle work and power manifested by the Spirit-filled 144,000, it yields the great multitude which no man can number, the second fruits of those who never die. So with all the references that I use as bringing out the antitypical harvest of humanity, first among the dead and then among the living, because it involves both the first fruits and the second fruits among the dead, as well as among the living, and both have way blows and way sheep, and all those that shall be saved. Everyone is included. That's all I have to say.
And this tells us about the antitypical harvest of humanity. How does this brings in, well, that there is to be, and there is, the Rod talks about a harvest of humanity. Yes, I see looking at the living and the dead separately. I see dead and I see living, but how does it help me to understand that there is a harvest of humanity, the coming together of both together.
Yes, and that's another reference, if I may. I just wanted to set the stage, but yes, there is a, yes, I can do that. But right now, that's what I have.
Okay. So what is this miracle? It says, accordingly, the antitypical pre-Pentecostal harvest takes place in a self-deceived church delivered east in the house of God through miracle work and power manifested by heaven itself in the angel.
Ezekiel 9.
Okay. Because there is a confusion of those who are fighting the truth that this is talking about miracles going to be done. The miracles wrought in TM testimonies to the church, page 126, is being confused with this statement. Whereas this statement is speaking about Ezekiel 9. Okay, anyone else?
Thank you, I released the mic.
We have our brother Victor Milana. Brother Victor.
Greetings, Brother Leonard.
Greetings,
Church. Can I be heard?
Yes, you can. Yes, you can.
Audible.
Yes, you are. Are you getting, is your speaker working? But I can hear you.
Oh, I can hear you now. My volume was low.
Okay. Yeah, that happens to me.
Sure. Thank you. I have track number 9. I don't know if we've read this already. Track number 9, page 41, paragraph 1.
Okay.
Yes. It says, the mountain, the kingdom of God, clearly then, is begun with the first fruits of the living, the 144,000, and followed by the second fruits of the living, the great multitude, Revelation 7:9, and is completed with the first and second fruits of the dead, the 120, those who received the Spirit on the day of Pentecost, plus those who arose with Christ, Matthew 27, verse 52-53. Plus the great multitude who accepted him after the Pentecost, Acts 5:14. Plus all who awake to everlasting life in the resurrection of Daniel 4:2. Plus the remaining dead of all the elders who rise on the great resurrection day, Revelation 26. Also, those of Ezekiel, the 7:1-14. In this statement, we see that the Lord is coming not only for the living, but also for the dead. And we have a couple of groups mentioned here. So It actually shows us the total harvest of humanity, that everyone else who's died
and everyone else who is going to be found alive, this is what Christ is coming for.
Thank you.
Amen. This is, and notice, the living are separate and the dead are separate. So, and in this particular statement, it shows that those who resurrected with Christ are among the dead, not the living.
Indeed.
For the taste of death. So you have two separate and distinct gatherings. First, you have the dead, then you have those who are to be translated to separate harvests, coming together to cause, to form the harvest of humanity. And that's where the statement in tract number 3, page 82, brings them together. Give you the, and that's why it says living and dead. Wave sheaf, wave loaf to the living and the dead, together comprising the total fruits of the antitypical harvest. This is the total fruits of humanity. Okay.
Next, we have our sister, Eileen. Sister Eileen.
Greetings in Jesus Christ. To the whole church, greetings.
Donc, dans tract 3, 46, paragraphe 3.
In tract number 3, page 46, paragraph 3.
Montrant de manière imagée. Il viendra sur la terre avec ses anges.
Voilà. Paragraph 3. In graphic demonstration.
De manière imagée.
Vas-y, Baptiste. Montrant de manière imagée qu'il viendra sur la terre avec ses anges.
C'est bon, sœur Aline. Merci. Je vais dire en anglais. In graphic demonstration that he will come to earth with all his angels to execute judgment upon the living, the Lord revealed himself prophetically to Ezekiel as being brought enthroned to earth by four living creatures just before the slaughter of the Ifrits in the church takes place. And as each of the living creatures has the face of a lion, the face of a calf, the face of a man, and the face of an eagle, the same judicial insignia as have the beasts who are before the throne in the heavenly sanctuary in the time of the judgment of the dead. And as they descend to earth, they thereby symbolically show that the work of the mediatorial judicial throne, which convenes and presides over the judgment of the dead, is extended to earth. Sœur Aline. Sœur Aline. I cannot hear her.
Ah, c'était fermé, excuse-moi. Donc je disais que...
So I was saying...
Le même symbole du jugement comme ceux des bêtes qui sont devant les trônes du sanctuaire céleste au moment du jugement des morts, alors qu'elle descend sur la terre, montre donc par ces symboles que l'œuvre du trône judiciaire et médiatrice qui se tient et qui préside au jugement des morts s'étend aussi sur la terre. Donc,
she read the last sentence, the same judicial insignia to extend it to earth.
Donc, par ces mots que l'œuvre du droit judiciaire et médiatrice qui se tient et qui décide au jugement des morts s'étend aussi sur la terre.
Voilà. Donc, là, quand je dis la terre, c'est.
So, when I said earth.
Quand je dis sur la terre, c'est.
Donc, les morts ont pris fin et.
So, the dead.
Le jugement des vivants, donc, c'est en sur terre.
The dead, for the dead, it is over, and then the living, the judgment for the living, begin.
And what does that have to do with the antitypical harvest of humanity?
Cela a-t-il avec la moisson typique de l'humanité?
S'étend aussi sur terre, ça veut dire que.
It's extended to earth, so it means.
Donc, comme les morts sont fins et à plus fin,
so
donc
as les the dead is over, then.
À plus fin pour les morts, alors. Cela commence.
Pour les vivants,
c'est ça, sur les.
Pour les vivants. It begins with for the living.
Well, this statement would not help me to understand that there is an antitypical harvest of humanity. It just tells me that the judgment is extended to earth. Nothing to do with helping me to understand the antitypical harvest of humanity.
La moisson typique de l'humanité.
And the references we're supposed to be supplying is references to support the illustration.
Illustration.
And this reference do not support the illustration of antitypical harvest of humanity. Especially that many have never heard it or considered
it.
So you need to make sure you have something to convince that the rod is speaking on the subject and explaining what you're trying to illustrate. Okay.
So can I take another quotation?
Another one?
Another quotation.
Does it have to do with the antitypical harvest of humanity? Just don't give me a reference. Does it have to do with the harvest of humanity? Does it help me to understand the harvest of humanity?
So yes, track number 3, page 85, paragraph 4. I think it's in red already.
Paragraph 4.
That one is read already.
Donc,
82, paragraph 4. That was read already.
Quelle page, Sœur Aline, s'il te plaît?
Chapitre 83, paragraph 4.
83, paragraph 4. Ça commence par quoi, Sœur Aline?
Donc, ça commence et par le même principe de la logique, la gerbe et le pain agité.
Oh, okay. So, it is 85. She just missed up the page and it has been already read. C'est déjà lu, déjà, sœur Ali.
Ah, c'est déjà lu. Ah, ben d'accord. Ah, ben bon.
It's already read. Okay. All right.
Harvest. Sister Patricia.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Yes, greetings and happy Sabbath. The quotation from chart number 9, page 65, paragraph 3 and 4. And it says, all paragraph 3 and 4, all who have acknowledged and profited by his might in the past, along with all who will acknowledge and profit by his might in the future, are to be found in 5 groups in the kingdom. These groups are: 1, the 144,000 Israelites, first fruits of the living, whose nobles shall be of themselves, and whose governor shall proceed from the midst of them. They shall return to Jerusalem and stand on Mount Zion with the Lamb. 2, those whom John saw after the sealing of the 144,000 gathered from all nations and kindreds and people and tongues during the great tribulation, the time of trouble such as never was, the great multitude who go to Jerusalem before the resurrection. 3, those who arise to everlasting life in the resurrection of Daniel 12 verse 2. 4, those Israelites who shall come forth in the resurrection of Ezekiel 37, verse 1 to 14. 5, all who come in the resurrection of Revelation 20, verse 6, collectively. These are all the Israelites and Gentiles who shall return to Jerusalem, possess the promised land, and then the whole earth. So, that statement shows those who has to be in the kingdom in the future. It says are to be found in 5 groups in the kingdom, and this is those that the Lord comes to take to heaven. That is the whole humanity, the whole dead and living together.
Yeah, but this statement does not directly talks about the harvest. It is showing all the groups, and it is shows that humanity is the entire humanity is going to be in the kingdom. Mm-hmm. And it does mention the first fruit of the living, and it mentioned the great multitude of all nations. Mm-hmm. But this statement does not have the effect as the statement in 41, because the statement in 41 is actually talking about first fruits and second fruits, and first fruits and second fruits, which really keeps it in the realm of the harvest.
Harvest.
So directly, okay, is speaking concerning what we're trying to show, rather than this is showing the groups.
Oh,
because all these different statements with the groups, they're trying to show something from a different angle.
Angle, okay.
So, because then we have the parade and we see everyone is going up in the parade, but it's always to keep it with what you're trying to focus on is actually harvest. So you want the statement to be having to do with the harvest, because this is a very difficult subject, And it's very confused. It's most is the most confused because it's essential.
Amen. Thank you for that.
Mm-hmm. And I, as we continue, I would like to just read that statement as we move to the next. Let me just read that statement. And it's not. In track 3, third edition, the rod begins with the statement, confused because essential. And the rod says, though it is the crowning work of our salvation and of the setting up of the kingdom of Christ upon earth, yet the investigative judgment is one of the least understood and the most mystified and confused Bible subject of the age. So when we're dealing with the ceremonial harvest, we have to keep this in mind, where we have to understand that we need to make sure we try to keep it as simple and brief, because we're dealing with something that is essential, and the devil has spent much time on confusing it. And it's the most mystified and confused Bible subject of the age. Were it not essential for our salvation? So the understanding of the ceremonial harvest, the understanding of the investigative judgment, is very important. It is essential to our salvation. Some say, no, this is not essential. All we need to do is love Jesus. Well, is it not Jesus that gives us the book of Revelation? It is not Jesus that gives us the law. Is it not Jesus that gives us the parables? You see, the enemy always try to divert God's people from what is important for their soul salvation. The enemy would not have expended every possible effort to envelop it in darkness. That is why the Lord gave us the ceremonial harvest in the sequence, in the different progression. Because if it's in one place, the enemy will make shipwreck. So the Lord has strategically placed it in several places, and you can see the truth from all these different angles, and he cannot envelope it in darkness, because every time he tries one, you have another one. You have another way. But this is what we must understand we're dealing with. Imperative, then, it is the unremitting need to search the scriptures as for hidden treasure and to beseech God for the guidance of his spirit in order rightly to understand this all-important subject. So this subject that many say is confused, they're confused and they don't even want to study it and they don't want to hear about it because this is not really salvaic. Well, it is according to the rod. And we must spend our time understanding it. And it is something that you will misunderstand and then understand. It is not something you can readily get it. It is something that you have to get it one piece at a time. And the illustrations that we're seeing here, it help you to go one step at a time. And you should not advance until you understand the section. And you study it and you study it until you get it, because it is the most important. Therefore, it has to have the most protection on it, because the devil expends every effort he has, everything he can do to confuse it. And we see this again in the rod in the White House recruiter. It says, in vain though any search for truth, unless the motive be to learn and to do the will of God. Listen to what it says. It is vain if you're trying to learn this without the desire to do the will of God. So when you learn it, then you have to do what? You have to live it. You have to live as though a harvest is coming. Live as though today is your last day. Some of you may say, well, we know the harvest is going to take place in the first month. So once that time is passed, I can do whatever I want until the first month rolls by again. My dearly beloved, the only day that you have promised to you is today. So today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Do not put off thinking that you have all these days. You don't know how many days you have left. So you should live each and every day as if it is your last day, and study and understand this all important truth. If any man says Jesus will do his will, he will know of the doctrine, whether it be of God. If any man will do his will, what is that saying? Only the obedient will know if the doctrine is of God. Others will only know what someone else told them, because they're not obeying, because the word of God says, cease ye from man. And if you're not studying, then you have to depend on what someone tells you. But here it is, the Lord says, will do his will. If you will do his will, if you will obey the truths you already have, the truths that you received when you first became a Christian, surrender, give your life to Christ, being born again, when you obey those truths, then you can recognize the doctrines, whether they're of God or whether it's a man concoction. And you would never understand this particular subject if you're half-stepping. If you're not obeying God, you could never understand this ceremonial harvest. You will never understand it, because you can only understand this truth when the Lord gives it to you. And well, it says it right here. And in the next paragraph, it says, I just read track number 3, page 3, paragraph 1, 213 in the series. Paragraph 2 says, since the subject of the judgment is taught in types, in parables, and since the Lord explains that his teaching parabolically is so that only the disciples may know the mysteries of God, mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, obviously, every time the Lord says obviously, the video is confused. Obviously, therefore, none, listen to the word, none but his followers can understand the whole truth. None. And who are his followers? If any man will do his will, he shall know the doctrines, whether it be of God. And anyone following and obeying, a follower obeys Christ and follows him whithersoever he leadeth. You will understand the whole truth. And my dearly beloved, do not be discouraged if you're having a little difficulty getting it. Oh, my dearly beloved, it is not a subject that you can get overnight. You have to keep at it. But you have now the illustrations, you have the references all pulled together, so it will be much easier. Once you get this, the foundation, you can now build on other references and always make sure to reference. Because we are studying so that we can give a reason. And that's not the only reason, that's the only reason why we're studying. But we must study to give a reason for the hope that is within us with fear and trembling. And with a desire for the person you're explaining to see the truth. And when they see the truth, they will want the truth. Because this is how beautiful the rod message is. So don't be discouraged. Just keep at it. I began studying this subject in 2002, I think it was 2002, definitely 2003, and I'm still learning it. And what I understand today is not what I understand in the beginning. But as you study it, it becomes clearer and clearer, but it takes time. You must take the time to study it and be able to give a reason for the hope that is in. You don't have to give the person a study with giving all the references, but you must be able to give them a part of it that will convince them and ask so that they will want to go and study it and see that the rod is clear. And it's not the rod, it's just what you have been taught. Because the rod is very clear on what his teachings are. Okay. He will get back to. What was that?
We still have one hand raised on that question.
On that same question. Okay, go ahead.
Yes, Sister Aileen.
For a reference, given a reference. I don't see a hand.
Yeah, I can't see her too.
Maybe she
dropped off. Sister Aileen, are you still there?
Maybe she dropped off.
Okay.
All right. Statement was read before, but we'll go now. The statement was already read. Now I've added harvest title and the typical harvest of grain. Give a statement why we're introducing now the typical harvest of grain, because on the first statement, we introduced the type as the noadic. But now, here, we're introducing the typical harvest as the harvest of grain. Why is that? Versus the noadic, which is supposed to be the typical. It laid the foundation, it established the truth. So shouldn't we now build on the noadic? Why are we now getting to the typical harvest of grain? Show why we're now introducing the typical harvest of grain. some of the references are already used. So the reference can still be used again for different subjects. So these statements do cover many different sections of the illustration. So why are we using the harvest of the grain as the type?
When I first said noadic is the type, now you come in with the typical harvest of the grain. Why did you transition?
No hand raised yet. We have Gloria.
Greetings, Brother Leonard to the church. Can I be heard?
Yes, you can.
Okay, this was given on track number 3, page 75, paragraph 2. And it reads, illustrating our salvation is completeness. The harvest rites of the ceremonial system must therefore corroborate both the testimonies of the prophets and the parables concerning the harvest, but are intricately bound up together. The ceremonies of the first and the second fruits of grain must accordingly unfold the truth concerning the first and second fruits of humanity. So this is saying that now that the first and second fruits of grain, they're unfolding the truth concerning the first and second fruits of humanity.
Okay. But why we can't use the noadic? Why we have to switch over?
Because this is showing us that it's unfolding the truth regarding the fruits of humanity.
But what happened to the noadic?
What happened to the noadic? I can't answer that question. I don't want to say that more light was shed on it.
What does the rod say? What did the rod say about the noadic?
He said that it was indispensable and therefore must be accounted for.
And what else? A key factor. That is true, but what else?
That it is the foundation of the church.
Yeah, but how would we know how would we know it? What is the problem with the noadic?
That is not, it's not written.
Exactly. Yes, it's not of record. The only one is of record is the apostolic. But we need a type. Therefore, the Lord used the grain as the type. But the noadic, it's not of record. That's why we have to switch. Okay.
Sure.
Thank you. Any more?
We have Sister Jillian.
Thank you again. And yes, Brother Lenos, because you mentioned your initial question, we have to have a place to start with, and the grain is the actual type. I want to go to three symbolic, I'm going to use two references only, three symbolic code, number 5 and 6, page 13. It's page 13, column 1, paragraph 1. And I'm using this reference to set the stage for the type of all that we're seeing on the screen. It says the query is answered in track number 3, the harvest. In the illustration on page 44, which the barley sheaf.
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Okay.
The harvest in the illustration on page 44, of which the barley sheaf of the first fruits is pictured in type and antitype. That is, the ceremonial sheaf of barley prefigured the resurrection of Christ, the first fruits, including those who arose with him. These resurrected ones constituted the spiritual sheaf, which at the beginning of the judgment of 1844 was offered before the Father as a sheaf offering of the living first fruits. End of quote. The reason I use that reference as it relates to the grain is because to set the stage for the spiritual harvest, we have the grain harvest, which pointed, that sheaf being waved, pointed to Christ, and it was the first ripened grain when we're dealing with a grain harvest. So it pointed to Christ and those who resurrected with him is the reason I'm using that reference, just to show that the grain harvest is the type.
Okay.
Before we get to spiritual.
Okay. Because harvest. The question I'm asking is, why am I using the grain harvest as the type, as the typical on this side?
I'll couple it with this next reference, but in this reference, I used it to support it's the type for a spiritual harvest of humanity. That's why I used it. Am I misunderstanding that fact? Or is it not?
No, it's just focusing on the wave sheaf, which is part of the ceremonial harvest.
But the grain pointing to fruits of any kind, it started with a grain harvest because the next reference will be that double application in 82, paragraph 4 of a wave sheaf and wave bowls to be in a harvest. Well, first harvest, first fruit harvest, as to why we need that as a type instead of apostolic or noadic or even in our time, the grain harvest I'm seeing is the foundation of this understanding, the ceremonial harvest. So I use this reference coupled with track number 3, page 82, paragraph 4, just to show why we use it as opposed to noadic, which is not even on record to use and prove it, anything to anyone.
Okay. But with the grain harvest, we're not limiting it to wave sheaf. The grain harvest is not limited to wave sheaf. So a statement to show that the grain harvest is the typical harvest. I mean, yes, this is showing wave sheaf.
Okay, I see what you're saying. Well, I was just going back from the angle of why using that versus noadic, because you mentioned it before I even got on. But the reason, like when you first introduce how important this is, picture anyone trying to show anyone anything that's not written, and the noadic, the question was, why not that? We can't even use that because it's not recorded. But I see what you're saying. Even though I'm using these references for the grain harvest, it just focuses on the wave sheaf and wave blows. But you're asking, if I'm understanding correctly, why grain harvest, but use some reference or references that also incorporates the other part to the grain harvest, because they are first fruits as well in the grain harvest, not just wave sheaf. And
there's first and second fruits in the grain harvest.
Right.
And this is not limiting it to any particular. It is limiting the total harvest, the entirety of the harvest. So rather than focusing on wave sheaf, we need to focus on a totality of the ceremonial harvest as a type. We know why the noadic cannot be used, because it's not on record. But God knows we need a type. So he gave it to us in the grain.
Right, but these references I'm giving is only limited to the wave sheaf and wave flow. So that means I won't go to the next one because that also limits it because we're talking about a double application. So you don't have to go there. I'll just release the mic and come back if I need to.
Okay.
Thanks.
Statement that is more inclusive of all, rather than focusing on the wave sheaf or the wave loaf.
Next, we have our brother group.
Oui, salutations à nouveau.
Greetings again.
La citation que je prendrai pour montrer cela, c'est
The statement I will take.
Ce sera Tragédie des siècles, page 432.
Will be a great controversy.
Page 432.
Quel paragraphe?
Je recherche en français.
Great controversy, will be page 399, paragraph 4 or 3. She's looking for the paragraph.
Paragraph 2.
So it would be paragraph 4. 399, paragraph 4. In like manner, the types which relate to the second advent. So, est-ce que je dois tout lire? I ask her if I have to read everything.
Get to the part which tells
us. Que la première partie.
Just go to the section that tells us about the grain harvest being the typical harvest.
C'est quoi la première partie, sœur Karine? Ça s'arrêterait où?
C'est alors la partie qui parle des céréales, c'est 431, paragraphe 4. Mais
So the one who talk about the grain, so it is the paragraph 3 then. C'est ce que tu veux dire, c'est type?
L'immolation de l'agneau.
Ok, donc je dois lire tout le paragraphe. So paragraph 3. Okay, it says these types were fulfilled, not only as to the event, but as to the time. On the 14th day of the first Jewish month.
Patricia, c'est le paragraphe avant. C'est le paragraphe avant. L'immolation de l'agneau pascal.
So she said the paragraph before, so that is paragraph 2. The slaying of the Passover lamb was a shadow of the death of Christ. Says Paul, Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. The sheaf of first fruits, which at the time of the Passover was waved before the Lord, was typical of the resurrection of Christ. Paul says, in speaking of the resurrection of the Lord and of all his people, Christ, the first fruits afterward, they that are Christ at his coming. Like the wave sheaf, which was the first ripe grain gathered before the harvest, Christ is the first fruits of that immortal harvest of redeemed ones that at the future resurrection shall be gathered into the garner of God.
Where does this tell me about the antitypical
heart? Et si on prend la première phrase du par... Comment? J'ai pris ce paragraphe pour montrer que
I took this statement to show
la gerbe agitée en tant que
wave shift as
est préfigurative est préfigurative
of stock and
et là elle préfigurait la Christ dans la phrase de
typified Christ as a wave sheep.
Maintenant dans la moisson de l'humanité, on sait qu'il y a les morts et les vivants ensemble. Et le paragraphe suivant nous dit
living all together, but the following paragraph says these types were fulfilled.
Il est écrit que ça doit s'accomplir conformément au symbolisme lévitique. So the following paragraph says
these types were fulfilled not only.
Et le Lévitique.
This does not. These statements do not.
C'est-à-dire gerbe agitée, ensuite
pas agitée. These statements do not answer the question. I'm looking for a statement that answered a question. You cannot convince me who I am trying to understand this truth, and you're telling me something. You just presented an illustration that told me typical harvest is grain harvest. Over here, you told me no attic. Now you get me to the grain. You have to give me a statement in the rod to help me to understand that the grain harvest is the typical harvest instead of the noatic. And the reason is the noatic is not of record. So Christ had to put something on record for there to be a type. Therefore, give me a statement. Give me the statement that will help me to understand what you just illustrated. You're illustrating this.
And I am the student.
You're trying to get me to understand what you have illustrated.
Then let's go to track number 3. Quelle page? Sœur Karine, quelle page?
Page 75, paragraph 2.
Page 75, paragraph 2.
We just had that, didn't we?
No.
Yes. We just had that.
Right? Yes, we did. We had that one.
Okay. Who's next? If there's no other.
We have Brother Ewan Kocho.
Can I be heard, Brother?
Yes, you can.
Yes, good evening, Ron Lennox, Britain. Track number 97, track number 3, page 97, 2, mentioned already.
Track number 3, page 97, paragraph what?
Paragraph 2. Yes, I'm going to this paragraph because, let me read it first. It's plainly that.
No, I don't want you to go to this paragraph, Abbas. We have already established that. I want to know why are we over. You just illustrated typical harvest is the grain harvest. Why are you illustrating that to me? You have already illustrated this to me. I already understand that.
But the reason I'm mentioning this because it talks about three Pentecosts.
I'm not talking about Pentecosts.
I'm knowing that.
You have just placed typical grain harvest of grain. Now you have to show me why the grain harvest is typical. Is this something you're inventing? Because you show me a statement that says the noadic is the type. Now you're introducing the typical harvest of the grain. Remember what we're doing here. You are giving the study when you come to give me a reference. I have done the illustration. You give me the reason for the illustration. So I just illustrated typical harvest is a grain harvest. You must give me a statement to support that illustration. This statement is not.
So I can't ask questions during this showing of references as an answer. Can I not ask questions in between? Is that not possible? That's my question.
No, you have to follow the protocol of what is going on. I am asking you for a statement to support this. This is not you questioning me. I'm not giving a presentation. You are giving the presentation. Actually, you are giving the presentation. I am illustrating, but you're actually the teacher. So I am the student. You just show me typical grain harvest. Now you got to tell me why. And I hope everyone is understanding this is what is going on. I am giving the illustration, and you are telling me, you give me the reference to support the illustration because you're the teacher.
Thank you.
All right. So this is what is going on. Please understand this. We have gone over this over several times. So what I'm doing here is giving you a quiz. But the best way to give the quiz is to do what I'm doing. Because this subject is very complex. Therefore, illustration makes it much more easier. And I wanted to quiz you. I didn't want to give the presentation and then you quiz me. I'm quizzing you. Okay?
Man.
So what I'm looking for is, give me a reason why, give me a statement to confirm that the typical harvest, grain harvest is what it illustrated to be. Okay.
Next, we have Sister Jillian.
Next, we have who? I see the next.
Sister Jillian, if you're speaking, we cannot hear you.
Oh, her hand's not up. I don't see her.
Okay, we can have Brother Victor.
Can I be heard?
Yes, now you can be heard.
Oh, thank you. Brother sir, I have a statement in tract number 3, page 81, paragraph 4. All right. This statement shows that the harvest of grain is the typical one. It says, the Feast of Tabernacles was not only commemorative, but typical. It celebrated the ingathering of the fruits of the earth and pointed forward to the great day of final ingathering. And the Lord of the harvest shall send forth his reapers to gather the tares together in bundles for the fire, and to gather the wheat into his garner. At that time, the wicked will all be destroyed. Patriarchs and Prophets 5:1. So I'm putting up this statement because it tells me here, it tells us that the ingathering of the fruits of the earth, which is the grain harvest, was typical, and it pointed forward to the final ingathering when the Lord of the harvest is to send forth his reapers. Now, not to gather the fruits of the earth, but humanity. And this will be the time when the tares are going to be burnt, whereas the wheat, the righteous, are going to be put into his garner, the kingdom, the church purified. So from here we see that the grain harvest, the fruits of the earth, were typical of the harvest of humanity. That's the statement I had, a quick one.
Thank you. So what is this Feast of Tabernacles?
So
you have introduced something to me that you didn't illustrate to me before. Now you're telling about Feast of Tabernacles. What is that?
Okay.
You're teaching me something. You're trying to get me to understand. Now you introduce something to me that you never mentioned. The Feast of Tabernacles. Where is that on your illustrations? What is the Feast of Tabernacles?
Oh, yeah, for sure. This is.
You're putting me in confusion now.
For sure. For sure. I concentrated much on the fruits of the earth as being typical, and not so much on the Feast of Tabernacles.
Yes, yes, you are, but I'm a student that you're teaching something to, and you never mentioned Feast of Tabernacle. Now you introduce Feast of Tabernacle, and I'm going to say, what is that?
So now, the Feast of Tabernacles.
I don't need to know it now, because you did not give it to me before, so why are you introducing Feast of Tabernacles now to me?
Okay.
You just throw something up here. For me to learn, now you tell me, but you're introducing another subject altogether? You explain something that you just put up here?
Okay. And hence, I put up concentration much on the fruits of the earth.
My dear brother, that does not help me to. I want to understand why you put that statement there, why you put that illustration there. And don't give me something that I don't know of. I don't know Feast of Tabernacles.
Oh, sure. I see it.
You see what I'm trying? I'm trying to get you to understand. Take your students step by step. Give them, let the rod speak with a statement. And don't give them a statement that you have to understand, you have to explain and all this different stuff. By the time you explain it, they're going to have another thing to introduce, because you explain this to me. I'm going to tell you, what is Feast of Tabernacles? I know what you're saying? Yes, I know what you're saying. I know what you're doing. You're trying to show if the Feast of Tabernacles is typical, then everything is typical. The entire setting is typical. Yes. But let your statements nail it. And don't give a statement you have to explain the person of the thing. You have them being focusing on illustration, give them a statement to seal it. If you don't have another statement, next.
Okay.
Next we have Sister Gloria. Greetings again, Brother Lennox and Church.
Greetings.
Track number 3, page 75, paragraph 3. We quote to Leviticus, and then I'm going to go to track number 3, 76:1 to explain it.
Paragraph 3,
and then I'm going to go to 76:1, which explains.
Okay, 73 was read, so let's go to 76.
Okay, it says, here we seek a man did the observance of 3 harvest rites, the ceremony of the wave sheep at the beginning of the first harvest, 2nd, the ceremony of the wave loaves at the close of the first harvest, and the Feast of Tabernacles at the close of the second harvest. Being typical, these 2 grain harvests with their 3 literal sacraments accordingly foreshadow 2 soul harvests with 3 spiritual rites, the first of which is the first fruits with wave sheaf and wave loaves. So what this is explaining is that the 2 grain harvest has 3 literal sacraments, and that foreshadows the 2 soul harvests that will have the 3 spiritual rites, the first of the first fruits, which have wave sheaves and wave loaves.
Amen. Since the Noahic is not of record, the Lord gave us the grain. And in this statement, it tells us exactly. It says, accordingly foreshadow 2 soul harvest with 3 spiritual rites. The grain is the type, because this is what the Lord gave us as the type. He did not give us the Noahic, even though we are told it is the type, but the details is not of record. But instead, he gives us the grain, and this statement solidifies why we can put that typical harvest of grain there as the type, because the rod says it.
Amen.
And that's where you want to take. Do not go and give something that you got to explain. You see, this is a tip of the day. Give a solid statement that hits it. There's no argument. The rod says it. 2 grain harvest, 2 spiritual rites. Human. Soul is human. This is the statement. Okay.
Who's Amen. Next we have our sister, Brother Terry Onestas.
And I want to remind everyone, please make sure you're taking notes. Make sure you're taking notes. Because if you're here in the quiz, it means you're taking notes so that you will be equipped later on as the weeks go by for the surprise quiz. So make sure you're taking notes as a good student. And if you have not been taking notes, make sure you get the recordings, go and take your notes as a good student is. For the surprise quiz, details to be announced sometime in the near future. Go ahead. Who's next? These are the last.
Brother Terry.
Greetings again.
Le tractatoire.
Track number 3.
76, paragraph 1.
Page 76, paragraph 1.
Mais j'allais le prendre depuis le tractatoire 75.1.
I wanted to have it, and I wanted to start it from 75, paragraph 1.
Okay. For the sake of time, paragraph 2 and 3 were read. And so we can read 75, paragraph 1. To add to what is already read. Go ahead.
Those whose vision is clear on the truth of the harvest as taught in the testimonies of the prophets and in the parables will have a still clearer vision as we study the significance of the wave sheaf, wave loaves, and the Feast of Tabernacles.
Okay, so you're adding that to the other two to bring the climax to 76, paragraph 1. Okay.
Yeah.
Any other?
We have our sister Celia is the last one.
Okay.
Yes, thank you for allowing me. I was going to use this reference, which Sister Gloria already used, but what I want to point out, and you can correct me if I'm not correct, the reason I was going to use it, because from your question, if we notice it says from the beginning, the ceremony of the way sheaf at the beginning of the first harvest is using the two typical grain harvest, which it's telling me, if I'm explaining to a student, that the wave sheaf begins the first harvest because you can't get the rest of the first fruits without the wave sheaf, and you can't get the second fruits without the first fruits. And so the grain harvest begins the entire antitypical harvest of humanity, which begins with the way sheaf, which is the beginning of the first harvest. That's what I wanted to share this reference to point out as to why the grain harvest is a type.
I would say you don't have to go emphasizing on anything at this point. What you have, the emphasis should be the two grain harvests with their three literal rites.
Well, you said why a type. That's why I was wondering, from my own understanding, why I would use it as a type is because the way she begins the harvest and encompasses every other part of the harvest, ending with the second fruits. But you're saying, you're talking about I don't need to emphasize that to a student.
Not from at this point. This point is just to show it is typical because it foreshadows the two soul harvests.
Right, I agree with you. I was asking for me, if I'm to understand what I'm understanding correctly, what I just shared, is that a correct understanding? I mean, just for me, I don't have to say all that to a student, but what I'm seeing with this reference is why the grain harvest is typical based on what I just shared. Just for me, am I correct in that understanding?
I don't see why you have to go back to the wave sheaf, and when you've got this right here, being typical, the two grain harvests, stop it there. You don't need to take your audio, take them beyond to go into anything else. When you get to the wave sheaf, then you can now get into that.
Oh, not for them, for me. I'm just asking you now that we're closing. Just for me, when I see being typical, the two grain harvest, it starts with the way sheaf, which begins the harvest. Is that a correct understanding for me? I'm not sure.
Yes, that is, you know, the first fruit harvest is the first harvest, and it begins with the wave sheaf. Right. That is, yes, that is obvious. It is. It says it right there. But
yeah, not to share with anyone.
Yeah, but it is, you will emphasize that when you get to the point.
with the two sections to the first fruit harvest, because the understanding, the teachings is there's only one section. So at that juncture is where you want to emphasize that when you get to the wave sheaf and the wave loaf, you will emphasize that because it needs emphasis when you get there, because it's part of the confusion.
Right, but for your question, the answer is the grain harvest is typical. That's why it's used as a type, because it's in the very language. It's typical.
Yes, and you can, you when you're given a study, you don't have to explain everything in a paragraph,
right?
Because you're gonna get back to it.
Mm-hmm.
But what you want, you read the entire paragraph, but you emphasize the part that is answering, that is it's answering the illustration. Now, when you get to wave sheep, you're gonna go back to the same text. And when you get to wave sheep to feast of time, you go back to the same thing, because you're dealing with each one separate and not in this conglomerate. That is not the rod.
Right.
Takes it just one step at a time. That's where you can understand it as well as those who you're sharing with. I understand it by going step by step. And the rod says a dog eats from the middle, but we should eat one spoon at a time. This is spiritual food. So you don't take the entire meal and stick it in your mouth. No, we take one spoon at a time. And you're not supposed to put another spoon in until that spoon that you just put in your mouth is thoroughly masticated and then swallowed for the digestive process to go on. So, yes.
Yes, and I thank you for that, because between us here, it's just a beautiful thing to see that the whole antitypical harvest begins with the wave sheaf of which we're purporting to be a part. So it was just solely for me, nothing more. But thank you.
Okay. Okay, praise the Lord. We will continue our quiz in the same format as we go through the prototypical harvest and with the wave sheaf and the wave loaves and complete the first fruit harvest. As our focus will be the first fruits, because that's where we're heading. We're getting to the first fruits. That is our goal. All right, praise the Lord. Let's have a volunteer to close us out in prayer.
We have Sister Gloria.
Let us pray. Loving and compassionate Father God, we thank thee for the beautiful hours of the Sabbath that has ended for some, and others are still in those beautiful hours. We pray as we begin the hours of the new week that we will enter into these hours of Christ continuously in our hearts, and that each moment and each day will bring us closer and closer to thee. Help us to be a light to those who are in darkness as we study and live thy truth.
Mm-hmm.
Help us to plant the seed of righteousness according to thy will.
Mm-hmm.
And to know that that's all we can do is plant the seeds, and that the omnipotent one in whom we live and breathe and have our being is to do the rest. Please keep thy protecting arms around us and our families, and help us, Father, to be stepping stones to thy kingdom and not stumbling blocks.
Mm.
We ask all these mercies in the precious name of thy only begotten Son, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ, and the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, praying and believing. Amen and amen.
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 praise his holy name, shall we gather in the kingdom and stand on Mount Zion with the Lamb. That's our hope. That's our blessed hope. And we need to understand the subject that gives us the plan and the details of this blessed hope. Let us continue to study to show ourselves approved unto God. And it is a subject that you will take time understanding it. But write yourself the illustrations and just go through it step by step. You will get it. It was not meant for you to understand all at once. So don't be discouraged. Just keep pressing on one spoon at a time. God bless you all. Love you all. And see you all next time, God willing.
Amen. Blessings.
Amen.